Now, when I talk about the piano action, most pianists understand this. This is what I'm talking about. What you're seeing here is the piano action. So there's a lot going on here. There are a lot of moving parts. I don't want to make this a complex presentation. If I were to name the parts, we'd be here for half an hour. But what I will do is I'll call your attention to the three major levers that are doing the work here, okay? And what you're looking for is you're looking for three linear actions that are moving in opposition to each other. And those are the three main actors in this picture that you're seeing here. The first one is the key. That one's pretty easy. That's the thing you're pressing down here, yeah? The next is the whipping. And that's this thing right here. The third thing is the hammer shank. So you can see the hammer shank is what is driving the hammer itself toward the string so that it strikes the string. Okay? So there are some other things. There's the jack, and I'll actually call your attention to the jack. And there's the the repetition bar. There's the backstop. There's the damper lever, and there's the damper. We'll talk about all these pieces in just a moment. But these are the main pieces that produce the magic. They make the sound happen. Now, one of the things that a pianist knows intuitively, but maybe if you're a pianist, maybe you don't think about this. So I want to call this out. Have you noticed that when you play a key, when you press a key, there's this bump right as you near the bottom of the key? You kind of feel this bump. When you play an electronic keyboard, you don't feel that bump. And that's the first thing that, whether you're thinking about it or not, lets you know you're not playing a piano. You're playing something else. That's called the let-off. It's also sometimes called the escapement. And what's happening essentially is there's a let-off button, and that's this piece of wood right here that is attached to a fixed rail in a piano. And this let-off button makes contact with the jack. And the jack, it causes the jack to move forward at just the right moment as it's rising toward the string. And when it gets at just the right position where it's propelled towards the string, it causes the jack to slip off the knuckle. That's what this is called. It's called the knuckle. So it slips off the knuckle and frees the hammer so that it can swing freely. Now, at that point, the repetition bar does what it's supposed to do, and the backstop does what it's supposed to do, and it kind of holds that, if you're still holding the key, it holds that hammer in a position that readies the hammer to quickly repeat the key if that's what you want to do. But that's what you're feeling. You're feeling that bump, and that bump is the jack slipping off of the knuckle, and that action is produced by the making contact with the let-off button. If that didn't happen, the hammer would press onto the string and you would never hear a sound, because the fact that it's pressing onto the string would stop the string from vibrating. It needs to be free, it needs to escape from the string in order to allow the string to vibrate. So that let-off is something you need to feel in order for your mind to tell you you're playing a real piano. And that's an important part of the action that you want to have if you're trying to find an electronic solution to a piano. Now, there's another piece of this as well, and really good hybrid pianos will also automate this part. So what's going on the left here? Well, we have something that's called the key end felt. That's what this red piece is here. The key end felt makes contact with the damper lever, and it pushes the damper lever up. Now notice it doesn't do it until the right moment. just as the hammer is nearing the string and ready to strike, and also just as the jack is about to make contact with the let-off button and slip off the knuckle, that's when the damper gets lifted. And the damper gets lifted again to allow the key to allow the string to ring. But in terms of what you're feeling is you're feeling the lifting, and not only that, but that damper lever is weighted. It's not shown that way in this diagram, but it actually has weights on it, because that damper needs to come back down onto the string, and it needs to come back down onto that string in such a way that it stops the string from vibrating. And in order to do that, it needs to be weighted, right? So there's a weight there that you're additionally lifting with your finger in a little bit late in the stroke of the key, and you're feeling that. So you need to feel the let off. You need to feel the lifting of the damper as you're playing the key. And you're intuitively feeling this when you're playing a piano, and when you're playing an electronic keyboard, you're not. Now here's another piece of this. When you lift the damper pedal, and let's take a look at the dampers. When you lift the damper pedal, there's a aluminum rail that lifts all of the damper levers up. And if all the damper levers are up, now when you play the keys, you're no longer feeling that weight laid in the keystroke, because they're already lifted up and you notice that. And when you're repeating keys or doing certain things, the key behaves differently and you feel that. Your mind understands all of this and your hands understand all of this. And that's why you tend to play differently when you're playing an electronic keyboard than when you're playing a real acoustic piano. And that's also the reason why when you try to play an electronic piano, you're never really satisfied. It's never really the same.